Hi, I'm Dr. Larry Malerba, and welcome to All Things Homeopathy. This is the first in a series of informational videos where I'll be talking about homeopathy, what it is, how it works, what it's capable of achieving, and why it meets with so much resistance. So let's get started. Homeopathy is a 200-year-old system of medical therapeutics based upon the law of similars. It is a holistic art and science that takes into account body, mind, and spirit, and is aimed at healing the whole person. It is a form of energy medicine that addresses energetic imbalances in the life force, imbalances that, if allowed to persist, can manifest as acute or chronic physical, emotional, and mental illness. There's a great deal of unfounded skepticism regarding homeopathy, probably because it is so different from the type of medicine that most Westerners subscribe to. Having attended conventional medical school myself, I can assure you that homeopathy is just as scientific and effective as mainstream medicine. However, homeopathy disagrees with regular medicine on a number of important points, including the origins and causes of illness and the most effective approaches to treatment and healing. I'll be talking more about these differences of perspective in a future episode. But for now, let's return to the beginning. Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, the founder of homeopathy, was a German physician who uncovered a peculiar phenomenon while he was translating a medical textbook from English to German. He was struck by the strong similarity between the symptoms that a toxic dose of Peruvian bark was known to be able to cause, and the symptoms of malaria. Hahnemann thought this was rather odd, given that the bark was also used to treat malaria. It turns out that Peruvian bark contains quinine. Nowadays, synthetic versions of quinine are still used by modern medicine to treat malaria. So Hahnemann decided to experiment upon himself. He ingested the bark until he developed fever, chills, and sweats, similar to the symptom pattern that one sees in cases of malaria, and thus began homeopathy and Hahnemann's quest to treat illness using the principle of similars. The good doctor went on to study many additional substances, documenting in great detail the symptoms that they could cause. He then used those symptoms as his therapeutic guide, giving small doses of carefully chosen substances to patients who exhibited similar symptom patterns. The resulting therapeutic success of his new homeopathic method was a revelation to Hahnemann, just as it has been to the practitioners who have used his method for the past 200 years. Having used homeopathy in my own medical practice for more than 25 years, I can attest to its effectiveness in treating the whole range of illness, from acute conditions like fevers, flu, coughs, viral illnesses, back injuries, sprains, strains, to chronic conditions such as migraines, arthritis, female health problems, asthma, anxiety, depression, phobias, and more. Homeopathy stands at the cutting edge of holistic healing. It has repeatedly demonstrated an ability to heal on a deep level medical problems that Western medicine can only manage symptomatically. Homeopathy is remarkably safe and rarely generates side effects. Its medicines are inexpensive and it can resolve chronic problems in a way that is inconceivable to most. If you'd like to learn more about this amazing system of healing, I invite you to join me for the next episode of All Things Homeopathy. Thanks for listening.